Hello guys, welcome to another tutorial on PHP. In this video I will show you how to do the update operation in the database connectivity using PHP. Update operation is nothing but whenever an user is entered data, later if you want to change the value stored, then we need to do the update operation. So let's begin. Open any text editor and create a new file. You can create give the name of the file to be anything, but I am giving as db update, so you will know I am doing the update operation in the database using PHP. Create a new file, save it as. Save it in the location htdocs, that is root directory, c xampp then htdocs. If you want to create a new folder, you can create it. Save. Now the file is created. As you all know, now we need to write the basic HTML tags. As I am using Sublime Text, the quotes are automatically inserted after the exclamation by using Emmet plugin. You can use that also. Now write the title appropriate, update a record in the database. Now create a form. We need to specify the method as post so that the data will not be sent through the URL. Create two text fields. The first input type text field is to identify a primary key field. Then the second one is the value which is to be updated, or to be precise, the second one is the new value which will be inserted. No, sorry, not inserted, updated, matching the primary key, that is UID. You will get a clear idea once we proceed. Create appropriate label so the user will be able to know what to enter in the text fields. Open the XAMPP server and start both the Apache and MySQL server. And then go to XAMPP localhost / php myadmin. This is where you can see the MySQL control panel, where you can manage the databases, tables, etc. I have already created a MyDB and a table user details. If you have not watched my previous video, you can go and watch, in which I had shown how to create a table and all. Now proceed. The type of the button should be submit, not type equal to button, because button does not submit the form. Input type equal to submit only submits the form. Now we will write the PHP codes which are necessary for the updation of the components or the field which is field which is in the database table. Using isSet method, so it will not allow the user until the submit button is clicked, or it will not provide the database connection or execute the query until the button or the form is submitted. I'm using post method, so the value will not be visible in the URL bar. As you can see, I'm specifying the name of the text field below in that $_post, so it will take the value exactly from the below, input type equal to text, name equal to uname, into that variable. And PHP's variable always contain dollar symbol. Now I am creating the connection object, passing the four values: localhost, since it's a local server, Manoj Selvin is my username, and Tantita is password for the database or the MySQL user which I had created earlier, and MyDB is the database associated with all that username. If the connection creates any connect error, then I'm saying the connection to die. Die is nothing but it performs as an echo, but it does not allow us to execute the codes that follow the die command. Follow after the die command. When the connection is successful, the codes inside the else statement will be executed. First, we need to create an SQL query for update operation. The syntax is update table name from update table name set value where condition. So update user details is a table name, set the new value. We are going to change the username. So set username equal to, we want the username to be taken from the new username should be taken from the input boxes from the user. Add the single quotes around the variable, so it will not be a string, it will be a variable. Where user ID equal to is the user ID, that is the primary key which is entered by the user in the first text box. Now we need to execute the SQL query. Query methods is used for executing the SQL query, and we need a connection object. So the connection object calls that query method with the SQL variable which contains the update operation SQL query. And when the query is executed successfully, it will return true, and we need to print echo username updated successfully. If there is an error, then we need to display the update failed error. And I am the steps, this connect error is not necessary as it is for testing purpose. Once the testing is done, you can remove that. We don't want the user to know what is the name of the table and where the error is occurring. We just want to know the update has failed. Now open the file, go to the browser and type in the URL bar http://localhost/db_update.php. Enter. As you can see, the form is now loaded. Adding required attribute makes the text field compulsory to be filled. It cannot be left empty. So as you can see, the user ID is 1 and the name is Manoj Selvin. Now I am updating. Username updated successfully. Let's check whether the update operation has stuck in successfully. Yes, the data is updated successfully, as you can see. So this is all about the update operation. If you want to add some styles to make it look good, we can add that. If anything is success, we can add green color to the font, and if any error has occurred, we can add red color to the font, which will make the display or the presentation good. Now let's check. Now update third value. Vinod name, change the name to Vinod from Vinod Selvin. Username updated successfully. Refresh the control panel. Yes, it is updating successfully. As you can see, there is no name associated with user ID 5, so nothing will happen in your database. That's it, guys. Thanks for watching. If you have any queries or doubt, you can comment down below. Or you can, if you like the video, you can press thumbs up.